I went out with your friend Carrie. I do not know where you come up with these people.
I told you my friends are all religious. The people I have been setting you up with are friends of friends. All I know is that she is extremely skinny, which you said you liked.
I met her at a diner. She was already sitting down and was wearing headphones, doing a word search. So it took a while to get her attention.
I didn't know that adults did word searches.
That is the least of her issues. I sat down at the table and she pulled her Bluetooth earbuds out of her ears. I noticed that they just dropped down as part of her earrings. I remarked how cool I thought they were.
That is neat. I have never seen those.
Let me tell you why. She shows me these big patches behind each of her ears, which she says holds the batteries for each earplug. She said she doesn't mind wearing patches. She then rolls up one sleeve to show me a large patch to help her to quit smoking, and rolls up the other sleeve, where she has had some vials inserted under her skin as a contraceptive.
Okay, I'll pass on the earrings.
I asked her if she would like to order and she replied that she doesn't really eat. While I looked at the menu, she took the salt shaker and poured a full ounce of salt into her palm and licked it up like a cat.
That's disgusting.
She smiled and told me she has an insatiable craving for salt. She then stood up and walked to my side and just stood there, looking down at me. I admit, I was petrified.
What did she do?
She put her skinny arms on my shoulders, bent down, and licked the beads of sweat on my forehead.
Oh my God. I'm sick.
She then whispers in my ear that I am cute and she wants to take me home.
What did you do?
I was frozen in my seat, afraid to move. I looked up at her, and saw a vision of a praying mantis licking its skinny arms, ready to rip off my head.
She's a nut.
I don't know why, but I let her lead me out of the diner. I was in a trance, heading off to a terrible fate. When we arrived at her building, the doorman looked at me, bit his lower lip and shook his head knowing I was lost. When the elevator doors opened on her floor, I looked down the long dark hallway and struggled for the power to escape.
What did you do?
As we walked, I managed to tell her that I was not in the mood. She asked me if I realized that mood backwards spells doom.
She's crazy.
She said that doing word searches lets her see words backward and forwards all of the time. She then stopped suddenly and said in this severe voice, "Did you know that penis backwards is snip?" And she makes this cutting motion with her fingers. I screamed at the top of my lungs and ran down the 8 flights of stairs.
I'm so sorry. I will set you up with one of my dear friends next. Keep in mind she's more religious than you.
Don't worry. After these past 3 dates, I've been doing a lot more praying.